One of the biggest obstacles in developing new drugs for everything from cancer or rare genetic diseases to COVID-19 is getting from an idea in the lab to a drug that can be tested in people. There's something known as the Valley of Death. On one side, academics churn out good ideas. On the other side, companies start testing new drugs in people. In the middle is a space that's too expensive for academics or requires expertise they don't have and is too risky to be of interest to industry. So few people go there and good ideas die. Stanford wanted to help more researchers navigate that gap. Doing that could help bring down the time and cost of making medicines and also mean more effective medicines reach patients. Those are the primary goals of the Innovative Medicines Accelerator. Stanford already had some campus resources to help faculty across the Valley of Death. The IMA acts as a sort of bridge, building on and connecting what Stanford had done in the past and adding new programs that make it easier for our scientists to get across. Some of these new programs help cross the first phase of the Valley of Death, speeding the process of taking an idea and making a drug that can be tested in animals. Others create alliances with industry, government, or nonprofits, so Stanford scientists can benefit from their expertise. But there's also a second part of the valley that falls between a more or less successful idea and a really good drug. The challenge is that most faculty get their ideas by studying laboratory animals like mice or worms or flies. And those ideas don't always perform well once clinical trials start. That's another place where drugs die. And it adds to overall healthcare costs when people invest years on an idea that doesn't work in humans. That's where experimental human biology comes in. That's where they first test ideas in humans or in human tissues, such as mini organs, like brain and intestinal organoids, in petri dishes. Any ideas coming out of those studies are more likely to make it to become drugs that are effective in people, which is the goal of the IMA.